Good morning, students. Here we come up with the gross anatomy of femoral sheath. Very important lecture. Femoral sheath. We will discuss definition, that is the formation, how it is formed. So first we'll discuss the definition, formation. Then we are going to discuss structure, that is the anatomy, structure or anatomy. Third, discuss regarding the structures which are piercing. What are the structures that are piercing the femoral sheath? And the fourth and the very important point is applied anatomy, that is clinical anatomy of the entire femoral sheath. Definition, that is the formation of femoral sheath. Now here, try and understand. It is a funnel-shaped facial sheath which will cover, please come on this side. It is a funnel-shaped facial sheath which will cover upper 3 or 4 cm of the femoral vessels beneath the inguinal ligament. So therefore, upper 3 or 4 cm of facial sheath, which is funnel shaped, and it will cover upper 3 or 4 cm of femoral vessels just beneath the inguinal canal. How it is formed is very important. For that we need to draw this diagram. First, let us draw alongside with me, please draw, this is the anterior superior iliac spine. And over here, we are going to draw the pubic tubercle. So, pubic tubercle, this will be the anterior superior iliac spine. And therefore, we are going to show inguinal ligament, which will cross the femoral sheath. But before that, we are going to draw the entire funnel-shaped femoral sheath. Now, please note down, this sheath is coming from the abdomen. So, therefore, formation, please note down the formation. Now, external iliac vessels which are lying within the peritoneum in the abdominal cavity, they are surrounded by extra peritoneal connective tissue, external iliac vessels. As they have the surrounding extra peritoneal connective tissue, these external iliac vessels will pass beneath the inguinal ligament. They will pass behind the inguinal ligament, and therefore, here I am going to show this will be the inguinal ligament. So the external iliac vessels are going to pass behind the inguinal ligament, and as they pass, they will carry along with them the surrounding extra peritoneal connective tissue. And this extra peritoneal connective tissue within the abdomen, where external iliac vessels are present here, they have anterior and posterior layers. The anterior layer, which covers the external iliac vessels, will be known as fascia transversalis, and the posterior layer is called fascia iliaca. So naturally, as the external iliac vessels, they extend just beneath the inguinal ligament, and then they will be known as femoral vessels. In the same way, the fascia transversalis and fascia iliaca will also naturally will pass beneath the inguinal ligament. And when these two layers covering the external iliac vessels, one is anterior, one is posterior. Anterior is fascia transversalis, posterior is fascia iliaca. When they pass behind the inguinal ligament lower down, they are themselves converted into femoral sheath. This is the formation of femoral sheath. So therefore, when we are going to draw the femoral sheath, please note down, the anterior layer of femoral sheath is formed by fascia transversalis, and the posterior layer of femoral sheath will be formed by fascia iliaca. So therefore, and these two fascia, that is fascia transversalis anterior layer and fascia iliaca posterior layer, will then fuse with the tunica adventitia of the femoral vessels. At what point? Around 4 cm below the inguinal ligament. So therefore, the femoral sheath is located only from just behind the inguinal ligament till the upper 4 cm beneath the inguinal ligament, where the femoral sheath will fuse with the tunica adventitia of the femoral vessels. So here, since we have discussed the definition, it is a funnel-shaped facial sheath. Since we have finished the explanation, that is the formation, we are going to draw now. And in order to draw this sheath, first structure that we'll draw will be on the extreme lateral side. Let us draw the femoral artery. So here I am going to write down the femoral artery. Then intermediate structure, please draw. Here I am going to draw the femoral vein. And the medial most structure will this medial most structure is femoral canal, and that will be empty at this moment. So after drawing this structure, these three structures, we are going to extend the artery downwards. So therefore, we are going to extend this artery down. This is where we extend, and this becomes the femoral artery. Here we are going to extend behind the inguinal ligament, of course, and we are going to extend femoral vein also. This will also extend down, and here we'll put some color inside the femoral vein. And after extending these two structures behind the inguinal ligament, and we are going to show that now it is covered by femoral sheath. So we are going to show the femoral sheath as orange color. And therefore, as we cover this as the femoral sheath, orange color, see that we are covering, we are showing this as cross section, and at the same time now, this femoral sheath, here we show it is having the oblique boundary. So now we are going to discuss the boundaries of femoral sheath. Now, at this point of time, here we have kept the space just medial to the femoral canal, and that space will be covered by an interesting ligament, and that ligament will be known as, for example, here I will draw this ligament as lacunar ligament. So this will be the lacunar ligament, and therefore now the entire inguinal ligament is crossing from the front. The entire inguinal ligament is crossing from the front. This is a three-dimensional structure of femoral sheath. Now we are discussing the entire structure of femoral sheath, that is the anatomy of femoral sheath. Please try and understand. After drawing this diagram, we are showing that the femoral sheath will have two margins. The lateral margin, this is the lateral margin which will be vertical, around 4 cm. The medial margin, please show here and write it as the medial margin is oblique. It is oblique, it is not vertical. Then the femoral sheath will have the lower part where the medial oblique margin will merge with the lateral vertical margin, and therefore it will have upper part, where this upper part we are showing it in a transverse section, where it is serving as somewhat the base, the upper part. Now here, this interior of the femoral sheath, when we consider the interior of femoral sheath, the entire femoral sheath, which is of 3 to 4 cm in length, is divided by anteroposterior septa into three compartments. The two anteroposterior septa will divide the femoral sheath into the three compartments. So therefore, since this is the cross section, we are going to show this as the femoral sheath, the cross section. I'm going to draw this transverse line to show that upper part we are showing it as a cross section. These two anteroposterior septa will divide the femoral sheath, interior of femoral sheath, inside the femoral sheath, into three compartments, and those three compartments are lateral, intermediate and medial. Now, what will these compartments contain? The lateral compartment will contain, number one, femoral artery, and along with femoral artery, it will contain the femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. So it will contain femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve also. So therefore, here we will show that it will contain femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve, this compartment, along with femoral artery. Then the next intermediate compartment, there is femoral vein. The intermediate compartment will contain femoral vein. And the medial compartment is known as femoral canal. This is very interesting. Medial compartment is femoral canal. Basically, this compartment is empty, except that it will contain one lymph node, which is known as lymph node of Clockwart. So this is a deep inguinal group of lymph node of Clockwart, which will be present in femoral canal, and this femoral canal will be bounded above by femoral ring. So therefore, the upper end of femoral canal will be bounded by this femoral ring. So I am highlighting this as the femoral ring. So upper part of femoral canal will be bounded by femoral ring. Remember, femoral canal is the medial most compartment, very short canal, and its upper part is bounded by femoral ring. And so therefore we are going to name this as the femoral ring. Sometimes you are asked in one mark question answer from the femoral ring and femoral canal. And also you may be asked in MCQs, what are the boundaries of femoral ring? Anteriorly femoral ring will have boundary as inguinal ligament. So therefore this will be known as the inguinal ligament, which will form the anterior boundary of femoral ring. Medially it is related to lacunar ligament. So medially the boundary is lacunar ligament. Posteriorly the inguinal ring will be related to fascia covering the pectineus muscle. It will be related to the fascia covering pectineus muscle. And laterally it is related to the compartment, intermediate compartment with femoral vein. So it is basically very simple, do not complicate. The femoral ring is the uppermost part of the femoral canal, where it will have the following boundaries: anteriorly inguinal ligament, medially lacunar ligament, posteriorly fascia covering pectineus, and laterally the intermediate compartment having the femoral vein. Now we come to, since we have discussed this, now we come to the basic of femoral sheath, where we find various structures which are piercing the femoral sheath. Before we relate to the structures piercing femoral sheath, let us write down or note down the anterior wall of femoral sheath. The complete anterior wall of femoral sheath will be formed by fascia transversalis. So therefore here, anterior wall of femoral sheath will be formed by fascia transversalis. Please note down. Posterior wall of femoral sheath, very important, please note down these points. The posterior wall of femoral sheath will be formed by the fascia iliaca. So please note down these two important points. So here the entire structure, the entire anatomy of the femoral sheath is complete. Now we come across to the structures that are piercing the femoral sheath. This is also a viva question, one mark question answer. What are the structures that will pierce the femoral sheath? From the lateral side, there will be one structure that will pierce the femoral sheath from the lateral side, and the name of that structure will be this nerve which is piercing, and this is known as the femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. So this structure will pierce the femoral sheath from its lateral wall. Then the structures which are piercing from anterior side. What are the structures that will pierce the femoral sheath from the anterior side? They are, please draw these three branches. One is this branch which I have drawn, and the name of this branch will be superficial circumflex iliac artery, a branch of femoral artery. Second will be, please draw over here, this branch, and the name of this branch will be the superficial epigastric artery. And then the third branch here, and this third branch you name this as superficial external pudendal artery. Both of these are branches of femoral artery. So all the three are branches of femoral artery, that is superficial circumflex iliac, superficial epigastric artery, and superficial external pudendal artery. These three branches of femoral artery will pierce the femoral sheath from the front. Note it down. Femoral sheath is pierced from the front by these three branches of femoral artery. Femoral sheath is pierced from the lateral side by the femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. And the femoral sheath will be pierced on the medial side, on the medial side by this wonderful vein which is coming here. This wonderful vein is known as great saphenous vein. So this great saphenous vein will pierce the femoral sheath from its medial side. So these are the structures that are piercing the femoral sheath, and here we are going to mark this as great saphenous vein. So these structures, please note it down, maybe asked in MCQs, maybe asked in viva, maybe asked in one mark question answers. Total 1, 2, 3 structures piercing lateral side, structures piercing anterior side, structures piercing the medial wall. Now we come to one important relation. Please try and understand. Based on this relation, you are able to understand the entire femoral sheath. saphenous opening. Yesterday we had discussed saphenous opening, and we have discussed in detail how the saphenous opening is formed. So we know that saphenous opening will have upper, lateral and lower margin, which is very sharp, which is called falciform margin. And that falciform margin I'm going to draw here. So let me draw this with which color? Violet color. I'll use violet color. Now from here, from the pubic tubercle, I'm going to pass this violet color, and I'm going to draw upper, lateral and lower margin. So this is the upper, lateral and lower margin of saphenous opening, and therefore this margin is related to anterior wall of femoral sheath. So the anterior wall of femoral sheath will be related to this margin. So in short, the upper, lateral and lower margin, that is the falciform margin of the saphenous opening which I have drawn, this upper, lateral and lower margin of saphenous opening which I have drawn will be related anterior to femoral sheath. It is related anterior to femoral sheath. And at the same time, the ill-defined, see here, I'm drawing the ill-defined medial margin. The ill-defined medial margin which I have drawn of the saphenous opening, this ill-defined medial margin will lie posterior to the femoral sheath. This will lie posterior to the femoral sheath. So please note this important anatomic pattern related with saphenous opening and femoral sheath. Do not confuse these two. So saphenous opening, this entire is saphenous opening plus, but you have to note down that the upper, lateral and lower falciform margin, which is very sharp margin of the saphenous opening, will be in front of the femoral sheath, whereas the ill-defined medial margin of the saphenous opening will go behind the femoral sheath, deep to the femoral sheath. This is the relation between femoral sheath and saphenous opening. So therefore this relation is very important. And after discussing this relation of the saphenous opening, let us also note down this saphenous opening. So here, saphenous opening. And after noting this important relation between femoral sheath and saphenous opening, so part of saphenous opening, upper, lateral and lower, is present in front of femoral sheath, and the ill-defined medial margin of saphenous opening will be lying posterior, behind the deep to the femoral sheath. Now, we come to applied anatomy. Now, this applied anatomy is very important and very interesting also. So, in the applied anatomy, coming up in the next. So, in the applied anatomy, here, please come on this side. In the, what's the name? Voice, yes. So, in the applied anatomy, here, we are going to write down the important point. The first point of applied anatomy will be, try and understand here, look at me, the female pelvis will be a wide pelvis, we know that. Because the female pelvis is a wide pelvis, the femoral canal will be wider. And because of the wider portion of femoral canal, as the femoral canal in females is wider as compared to males. So here, I put this arrow here. This will be the, as it is wider in the females, what will happen will be, there will be more amount of cases which are related with the femoral herniation occurring in the female pelvis because of the wider length of the female pelvis, because of the wider breadth of the femoral canal in females. So, femoral hernia, when it passes through the femoral canal, is more prone to occur in females as compared to the males. This is one point. Then, we come to the second point. Now, in the second point here, after discussing the femoral hernia, which is more predisposed to the females, we come up with the, in case of femoral hernia, as it passes through the femoral canal, always note down the direction. This direction is many a times which are asked in the applied anatomy or in surgical anatomy. What is the direction? The direction of the femoral hernia will be as it passes through femoral ring, through femoral canal, it is directed downwards. As it passes through femoral ring, through the femoral canal, it is directed downwards. Immediately, after directing downwards, it will be passing anteriorly. So downwards, then it will pass anteriorly, that is forwards. Instead of anteriorly, we will mention forwards. Forwards through saphenous opening. So as the femoral hernia, contents of femoral hernia, they are passing through the femoral ring, through the femoral canal, their direction is downwards. After downward direction, they will pass forwards through the saphenous opening. So downwards, forwards through the saphenous opening, downwards through the femoral ring, femoral canal, forwards through the saphenous opening, and then the direction will be upwards. Then the direction will be upwards, surrounding or across the falciform margin of saphenous opening. This upward direction is because it will pass around the saphenous falciform margin of saphenous opening. So therefore, this direction should be kept in the mind. Many a times this direction is asked. Even in MCQs there, it has been asked. What is the direction of femoral hernia? Downwards, forwards, upwards. So the direction will be downwards, forwards and upwards. Now, in order to reduce this hernia, in cases of manual reduction, the reverse direction has to be followed. So in those cases where there is manual reduction of this femoral hernia, the reverse direction has to be followed. Kept in mind, this should be kept in mind, that the direction of femoral hernia anatomically will be downwards, forwards and upwards, and the reverse direction has to be followed in cases of manual reduction. Now we come up with what are the coverings of femoral hernia. This is many times asked in one mark question answer. From inside to outside, the coverings of femoral hernia, they are, number one, the peritoneum, which covers the hernial sac, the innermost. Then external to the peritoneum, which covers the sac, will be the femoral septum, covering of femoral septum. Then external to femoral septum, there will be anterior wall of femoral sheath, the anterior layer of femoral sheath. External to that, there will be the cribriform fascia. This is cribriform fascia. And external to cribriform fascia, there will be the superficial fascia and skin. These are the coverings of the femoral hernia. This is many times asked by our one mark question answer. I'll repeat the coverings of femoral hernia from inside to outside. Peritoneum covering the femoral sac, then there will be the femoral sheath. External to femoral sheath, there is anterior layer of femoral, not femoral sheath but femoral septum. So femoral septum, first is peritoneum, external to that is femoral septum. External to femoral septum will be anterior wall of femoral sheath. Anterior wall of femoral sheath, external to that anterior wall of femoral sheath will be cribriform fascia. And external to cribriform fascia is the superficial fascia and skin. Now here, I have mentioned femoral septum. Please come on this side. We will try and understand what is femoral septum. We have discussed about the anatomy of femoral ring. Now on the femoral ring, where my hand is there, just on the superficial part, or rather the superior part of femoral ring, it will be closed by extra peritoneal connective tissue, which is known as femoral septum. So if I draw the femoral septum, I will draw the femoral septum in this way. So this is the femoral septum, which is extra peritoneal connective tissue, which is covering the upper opening of the femoral ring. So the upper opening of femoral ring is covered by extra peritoneal connective tissue, which is called femoral septum. Please note down, please draw this and please mark it. So here we are going to mark this as femoral septum. And on the femoral septum, since it is an extra peritoneal connective tissue, on the femoral septum there is depression. On this femoral septum there will be a depression which is lined by peritoneum. So therefore, that depression which is lined by peritoneum which is present above the femoral septum, that is called femoral fossa. Please note down, that will be known as femoral fossa. So what is femoral fossa and what is femoral septum? What is femoral ring? These are one mark question answers. I will answer what is femoral fossa. It is a peritoneum lined depression which is covering the extra peritoneal connective tissue which will form the femoral septum. So the peritoneum lined femoral fossa which covers the femoral septum is known as femoral fossa. So first there is femoral fossa, then there is femoral septum, and then that will be surrounded by the femoral ring, and below the femoral ring is femoral canal. So therefore, if we come on this side, that femoral septum will be the second layer in the layers which are covering the femoral hernia, that is the inside to outside, the peritoneum, femoral septum, anterior wall of femoral sheath, then cribriform fascia, and then the superficial fascia and the skin. Now, one more point, try and understand is, in the applied anatomy, one more point we are going to understand, and that is, basically femoral canal, in some books it is written beautifully, it is a dead space. So the femoral canal will function as a dead space. Where it will contain, what does the space contain? Small amount of extra peritoneal connective tissue and lymph node. This lymph node will connect deep inguinal lymph node with that of the external iliac group of lymph nodes in the abdomen. But basically this dead space which is provided in the femoral canal is provided for expansion of femoral vein. So therefore this dead space will function as, it will provide some space for the expansion of femoral vein. Whenever blood will pass through the femoral vein, it will need some more space for its expansion. So that space is provided by the dead space which is present in the femoral canal. Since the relation of femoral canal is, femoral canal will be lying medial to the femoral vein. Here we have finished the entire description of the femoral sheath. Thank you very much.